tauti mai anō. For most musicians, the dream is to make a hit song, make lots of money and make the big time. But for one Northland duo, making music that inspires the people in their small town while promoting te reo Māori is living the dream. Simi Ramis headed to Kaikohe to meet the funky North.
Hit the streets of Kaikohe and you can see the town's in a bit of a funk. There's unemployment, it's younger and poorer. Half the adult population earn less than $20,000 a year and 40% have no formal qualification. But if you scratch the surface and look underground, you'll find a culturally rich community where local musicians are turning the funk into beats and tunes to inspire the locals.
The Funky North is a collaboration between two local Kaikohe musicians, myself, Tremaine. We get together and make beats, make music and write songs and perform them. That's our whole mission, is to enjoy music, be creative and express our lives really in the community and express our, you know, our stories, which, you know, are the stories of lots of other people around us, of just the people of the Rohe. Sort of evolved naturally and organically out of, you know, myself, my brother and Tremaine got together one time a couple of years ago now and had an acoustic jam. My brother's a percussionist, played djembe, and I play acoustic guitar, and we just had some, you know, had some fun, and Tremaine was rapping, and we thought, hey, this sounds really cool, this is quite fun.
Brent and Trey both hail from Ngāpuhi, but only moved to Kaikohe a few years ago. With the economic state of this humble township and the recent crackdown on gangs in the area, both Brent and Trey say they want to contribute to turning things around through their music.
Us just doing what we're doing, we've been an example. Yeah, we've been an example to our community and to the young kids, just showing them that just because you come from a rundown town that has bad stereotypes attached to it, doesn't mean you can't achieve your goals.
The Funky North was formed in 2013. The duo have been writing, recording, performing and building a fan base through online content, community work, festival appearances and shows.
We supported Supergroove at the Bay of Islands Food and Wine Festival last year in October. We supported The Nomad, who, for anyone who knows underground bass music, knows who The Nomad is. We played at Tuhirangi Marae in Waimae a few weeks ago for a whānau thing that was going on there. So we've definitely put ourselves into different situations for gigs. Like, sometimes we'll just bust out the guitar and sing some classics, and that's appropriate for wherever we happen to be. And that's what we'll do. And then other times it's a hip-hop thing, so we can go that way.
While they've enjoyed opening for the big acts that roll into their small town, going mainstream like contestants on X Factor is not their thing.
You know, we're not ambitious in the sense that, okay, we want to, you know, get popular, then we want to get on TV or, you know, whatever. Like, we're not against those things and we're grateful for the exposure and attention that we do get. But when you've done music for a while, like I have, you know, and you've been in the trenches for a while, just the fact that you're still doing it and enjoying it and able to have the resources at your fingertips to make music and share it is, you can't be disappointed. You can't, you know, you've already achieved it. So anything that happens on top of that is a bonus.